Tell that we have a full house, so I'm super excited about that as well. And if you hear the pitter-patter behind me, it's because the guys are filling the stage, because they are even more nervous than I am, which is hilarious. They're so cute when they get nervous like this. The video that you watched was kind of an overview of our Clash of Classes experience that we, through Leadership Dynamics, where we raise some money. So thank you for buying a ticket. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being here tonight and supporting us in our quest to build a culture in this building that makes students want to be here. Because when they want to be here, we're going to get their best. And if we get their best, then there's the ripple effect that we cannot even imagine. So you're not going to hear from me all night, because we know how to put on a show. And with that, that means we have the best master of ceremonies in all of Henderson County. Put your hands together and help me here to the stage or microphone, the voice of Henderson, Steve Dow.
We're about to find the ladies and gentlemen. Good evening. It is my pleasure to be here for the third annual Mr. Colonel event. This is the third one I've had the opportunity to MC. We have been promoting it all week on the Keeping Up with the Colonel edition of the Steve Town Morning Show at WSON. It is our honor at WSON to be affiliated with such fine content. Now, with that, I will turn to my co-host and ask, based on the amount of rehearsal time and the two dress rehearsals, on a scale of 1 to 10, how is this performance going to turn out?
It's anybody's guess. We
get,
this will be maybe the second time that all 13 contestants are able to do this together in one spot. We want to give a shout out to how busy they all really are. But that's okay, and that's what I told them. This is about having fun and taking advantage of yet one more senior year experience, having the best time, because guess what? They're the ones that are here tonight. They're the ones that we're going to get to smile and laugh and make these memories. And at the end of the day, that's what it's all about.
I would like to take this opportunity, the first of the times that I will mention, my good friend and our good friend, Pam Fitzgerald-Clark at Gallery Gifts and Bridal. She allowed me to wear a tuxedo for the first time since June 4th, 1994. That was the day that I got married so many, almost 28 years ago. And again, that is at Gallery Gifts and Bridal on Main Street in
Henderson. And again, thank you so much to Pam Fitzgerald-Clark to help make this happen, the male version of the little black dress, as they say. How about a big hand for Miss Snowballs out there?
Thank you.
guys have been practicing for the past 3 weeks. Can anyone hear my mic? I didn't think so.
Hours upon hours of work went into making this such a successful evening. Punchline. Thank you. Indeed. All right. Voting directions, very important, Ms. Stovall. On the program, there's a QR. Anybody know what a QR is? Show of hands?
Yes. And that is going to be the QR for the voting directions is on the program.
So what we're going to do with the QR on the program, and I know it's dark, but during intermission, this will be one of the last awards that we give out. You scan the QR code, and there'll be a drop-down menu, and you as the crowd get to give out an award tonight and choose your favorite contestant. And so I think it's going to ask you to log into your account. We're working through the Wi-Fi and all, but we're going to, fingers crossed that it works this year, because we didn't get to do it last year. But that's how the QR code is going to work. And then we also have the Best Legs contest going on out in the lobby.
Okay. No silent option. Okay. We also ask, very important, please refrain from moving while the contestants are performing on stage. That would help a great deal. I would like to now have you meet our three judges for this evening. First, Kyle Sticks Forrester. From the class of 2002. He went on to graduate from Western Kentucky University in 2007 with a Bachelor of Science in Business Management and a minor in Marketing. Kyle is beginning his 14th year working for Gribbins Insulation, where he is now the Vice President of the Southern Region, which oversees the operations for their Louisville, Nashville, and Paducah offices. He has been an avid supporter of Henderson County High School and is currently in the middle of his 11th season as assistant basketball coach for the boys basketball team. In his free time, Cal enjoys spending his time with friends and family, as well as watching sports. He is married to Lindsay Forrester and has a 12-year-old stepson, Colby Sutton. And his favorite teacher of all time, of course, say it with me, Miss Ginger Stovall.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kyle Forrester.
Our next judge is Dr. Michelle Chappelle. Michelle Chappelle is an alumnus of Henderson County High School from the class of 1991. She is an associate professor in the Computer and Information Technologies program at Henderson Community College.
Also, she
is the program coordinator for the Computer and Information Technologies program and coordinator of Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion.
She is a mentor to underrepresented minority students at
Henderson Community College and then the Henderson community
to assist with closing the achievement gap.
Lastly, she
obtained her doctoral of education
specialization
in adult and
higher education leadership from Morehead
State University.
Yeah,
we had that in common.
She loves
reading,
music, no country, I mind you, binge watching on Netflix, and is a lifelong Steelers fan. Ladies and gentlemen,
Dr. Michelle
Chappelle. And our third judge
is Mr. Josh Bennett. If you can dream it, you can do it. That's
exactly what has happened to Josh.
Josh Bennett was born and raised here in Henderson County, and after many years boning and running, cutting
edge
lawn and
landscape, he decided to chase his dream of owning and operating a restaurant.
In January 2021, he took the first step of
making this dream
a reality
and opened Chef One,
Barbecue and More.
Josh and his wife,
Amy, really enjoy
the opportunities that has given them to give back to the community that
they love so very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Josh Bennett.
Okay, now for the talent portion.
The talent portion will hopefully prove to be one of the most
entertaining parts of the show.
They will sing,
dance, act, make you laugh, and no doubt impress you with their unique and
very creative
talents.
Please hold your applause
until the end of each performance, but don't forget to cheer on all of your favorites.
Remember, your
favorite talent
is
you will be able to cast your vote using your smartphone and QR code in the program. And with that, our first talent of the evening is contestant number one, Cole Parrish. Cole will be performing a new unique number. He has been a student of percussion genre of music for 7 years, falling in love with drums in the sixth grade. Why, you ask? Because they are the loudest instrument, of course. Sponsored by ERA First Advantage Realty, here is Cole Parrish performing a marimba solo. Is number three, Brecken Sauer. As one of the sports anchors of the Colonelcast News, Brecken is very familiar being behind the anchor desk. Here he is tonight to dazzle us with his talent of being able to read from a teleprompter and deliver the news. Sponsored by Sauer Farms, here is contestant number three, Brecken Sauer.
University of Southern Indiana. The Screaming Eagles are now preparing to make a leap from Division II to Division I. Thank you for joining me. I'm Brecken Sauer. USI's President Dr. Robert Sean says that the move from Division II to Division I is one of the most significant changes that the university has ever made. It's also one of the most impactful changes since gaining statewide independence nearly 4 decades ago. Monday's vote means that USI will apply to the NCAA cause of suffocation. And if conference beginning in the fall of 22. The Eagles will play in the Ohio Valley Conference. USI will be the 23rd full-time member in the 74-year history of the Ohio Valley Conference. That many students have, will the cost of tuition rise? Yes. This move will cause some additional funding. Cost of tuition up during a four-year period from $60 per semester to as much as $238 a semester in the 2025-2026 school year. As a part of the upcoming student body, I'm very excited to see your D1 schools throughout the country. That's it for this very short story, Screaming Eagles. Go Colonels, charge on.
Good job by Brecken Sauer.
Our next performance is by contestant number two, Breck Bender. Breck has tapped into the unfamiliar talent of painting, thanks to Mrs. Grace. Needing a talent for the event, he did what any of those talentless folks would have done. He phoned a friend, then maybe his debut performance with a paintbrush tonight will launch him into a career field none of us saw coming. Maybe it'll be the first of a lasting painting impression or experience, I should say. Judges, that's your call. Sponsored by Square Yard Carpet, please help me welcome contestant number two, Breck Bender.
What easel?
And thought about winging it in the moment, so there you go. How much fun are we having so far?
Just you wait.
Just keep starting. There's some things going on in the hallway out there that defy explanation, and we're going to let that take care of itself when they take it to the stage.
Admin, we'll get to watch the film back on the cameras.
Yeah, so anything that happens in the hallway is obviously being documented even as we speak. Our next performer will be contestant number four, Hayden Emick. Word on the street, Ms. Stovall, is that Hayden should have stolen the page from the book of Breck when it comes to searching for his talent. Phone a friend and Google it.
I think he did, which is how he ended up here.
Yeah, thank you. When faced with this challenge, he opted to try magic tricks, making his debut in his quest to follow, well, pick a magician.
Do you know a magician?
Bert Wonderstone. There's two people I know what I'm talking about. No. Anyway, sponsored by Chapel Heating and Air, ladies and gentlemen, contestant number four, Hayden Emick.
Told you I can make one disappear. Watch. And then whenever I pull this cloth off, it's gonna disappear. All right, so for this next trick, I'm gonna need a $20 bill from someone in the crowd. Is there anyone willing to offer up some money? There's some. All right. Okay. For this next trick, I'm gonna make this $20 bill disappear. So, you ready? Watch. I've been practicing that trick for like 16 some odd years, so I've gotten pretty good at it. That's all I got. Thank you.
No sound. There you go. That's better. Yeah, now we're good. Yes, what do you have there?
This is the only one in existence, the Mr. Colonel medal, that this year's Mr. Colonel is going to get to wear at graduation. Isn't that kind of neat?
Very cool.
Yes, special shout out to Family Sports and Bill Heath making this happen. And it has the Colonel on it, you can see, and the year. So it is the only.
No, sorry.
What did you just?
I bit it. I want to make sure if it's authenticity. No?
Sorry, everybody. We're the pandemic.
Yeah, we are.
So, with that being said, we have, as you see across the front of the stage, all of the decorations. They're really the prizes. And shout out to the Leadership Dynamics class for working so hard together. They were able to round up prizes for each of our award-winning contestants tonight. So, and no one's going home empty-handed. So that will save us a prize for later.
I want one of those car wash tokens I got last year.
Ooh, is there a car wash token in your future?
We'll see. All right, folks. Contestant number five, Jaden Deibler, when challenged with coming up with his best talent, Jaden spent time self-exploring, realizing his strength and talent lies in eating. I think a lot of us can identify. And he resolved to eating. Wait for it, folks. Cereal. But what does one wear when showcasing an eating talent? Ladies and gentlemen, sponsored by Gibbons Counseling, or Consulting, I should say, contestant number five is Jaden Deibler. Thank you.
spins a web anytime. Catches thieves just like flies. Look out, there goes that Spider-Man. Is he strong? This is nothing. He's got radioactive blood. Can he swing from a friend? Take a look overhead. Hey there, there goes that Spider-Man.
Some explaining, but I don't know where to start.
The crowd wants to know,
yeah.
Was that your Spider-Man outfit?
It was, from 1987. It still fits. My right foot.
Save the joke telling, if you will.
Yeah, well, coming up.
Well, we've
got coming in a few minutes. Once upon a time, camp, contestant number 6 was a confident colonel and finally disclosed one of his passions on a public platform.
Pause right there.
Okay.
Ready?
Yep.
Shout out to the FFA Club.
Oh, yeah.
Man, that was a creed.
You know what FFA stands for now. What does it stand for? FFA.
Because they changed it.
They took out because...
Oh, it wasn't a trick question.
No, it was not a trick question. I don't have... I'm not smart enough to bear those. So, each chapter had to bring a performance to the camp show, and our Henderson County High School chapter brought Travis and his hidden talent. He's gonna prove it in a big way, I promise you. Instead of performing on his own YouTube channel tonight, he is ready for his family to watch him take to the stage and make them proud. Telling dad jokes, sponsored by Silver Creek Transportation. Here he is. Travis Herndon, contestant number 6.
Am I good? Is it working? Okay, so I think before we proceed any further, because obviously I'm doing dad jokes, we must first establish, when does a dad joke actually become a dad joke? No, it's when it becomes apparent. Why couldn't the bicycle stand up on its own?
Why?
It was too tired. So, I was out playing in the park the other day, and I kept wondering why this frisbee kept looking bigger and bigger. Then it hit me! I like that one. So, yesterday, about the same time, I hit a clock. It was very time consuming. Especially when I went back for seconds. So, whenever I try and eat healthy, a chocolate bar always looks at me and snickers. Why is Peter Pan always flying? Because he never lands. Someone complimented my parking today. They left this really sweet note on my windshield that said, "Parking fine." Did you hear about the kidnapping at school? It's fine, he woke up. Yeah, he didn't miss the bell. What do you call a fish with two knees? No, a toonie fish. And I'm gonna leave y'all tonight with... I've used this joke twice now. Both times, it has absolutely killed. Why didn't the toilet paper cross the road? It got stuck in a dirty crack.
Well, well, well.
I think you would agree, Ms. Stovall, the bar has now been set very high. And Travis is the guy that's setting it. I can see the other ones reaching.
Are you asking for his email so that he can bring you up to speed?
Yeah,
yeah.
So I can have. I need absolute content, and he certainly can serve as a writer in that category. Our seventh contestant to perform tonight's talent portion is H.P. Hazelwood. At the young age of 9, H.P.'s mom felt he would be a natural pianist and quickly enrolled him in piano lessons.
Wouldn't that have been cute?
Oh my goodness, thank goodness we didn't own a piano. This didn't turn into his passion, but sure fit the need when he needed a talent for this show. H.P. has always been inspired by Snoop Dogg. Who hasn't?
How did you go from piano to Snoop Dogg?
I
wrote it.
Exactly. You're the one that wrote it. We should ask you that. He taught himself one of his songs, and he will play that tonight, playing Still Dre by Snoop Dogg, sponsored by E.M. Ford. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 7, H.P. Hazelwood. Got it?
Still got love for the streets, it's the D.R.E.
I'm representing for the gangsters all across the world.
Still
hitting the counters and the lolos, girl.
Still taking my time to perfect the beat, and I still got love for the streets, it's the D.R.E.
Since the last.
Snoop Dogg fans, but how many Dave fans are there out there? Woohoo, thank you. Appreciate it. Goodness gracious.
But how about that jacket?
Oh, man.
You wanted that crushed velvet.
I've seen more excitement when they say Henderson County would be on regular schedule tomorrow. I've had more excitement out of the crowd than when
now you lost.
In reacting today, exactly. Oh, my goodness. Our performance tonight is contestant number 9. That is Tyler May. Being a look-alike as Justin Bieber, or so he thinks, it was just as given his words, not ours, that he would bring his talent to the show and sing this song choice. It's one you will sing along with, so get ready for this. Ladies and gentlemen, sponsored by Allstate Insurance, deep agency, and no stranger to the stage when performing, contestant number 9, Tyler May, with his first try.
We're in his way.
At Justin Bieber. Well, he's going to have to. Justin Bieber, get
up. I know you care, shall we never, and I'll be there. You my love. You are my heart, and we won't ever, ever be apart. I'll be an idol, girl, quit playing. We're just friends, are you saying that there's another look right in my first love broke my heart for the first time. Baby, come on, baby. Oh, like baby, baby, baby. Oh, like baby. Baby, baby, touch me, baby, baby, oh, baby, 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 oh, baby, 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 oh, beautiful to be mine. Oh, you, I would die forever. And I just can't believe we get there. And I wanna play it cool while I'm holding you. Anything out by it. Say, baby, fit. And you shake me to wake me from a dream. Down. Running like baby. I can't. Oh, like baby, 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 oh, like baby, 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 oh, like baby, 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 baby and my Buddha when I was 13. There was nobody that compared to my baby. Nobody came between us, could ever come above. She had me going crazy. Oh, I was starstruck. She woke me up daily. Don't need no Starbucks. My heart down. Give a beat when I see her on the street and at school on the playground. But I really wanna see her weekend. Oh, she got me amazing. Cause she was so amazing. Now my heart is breaking. And I just keep on saying, hey everyone, I would like y'all to give an amazing round of applause for my amazing girlfriend for coming up here with me. I need you to turn around. So, wait, was that a yes? Did I get a yes? Is it a yes? It's a
No, didn't take a girlfriend.
Was it your mom?
Yes. As a matter of fact, it was my mom, my aunt, and my cousin. If I'm not mistaken.
Look, wait, the way this
when she said it, my mom and I said yes, there was no O's. When I say we doubled, there's where the O's come in. I think the O goes right back to you, all of you old sayers out there. But a lovely young lady. She doesn't want me to tell her name since the incident. But anyway.
But Justin Bieber being in the house.
Yeah.
That is not the only celebrity we're going to see emulated tonight.
No, I'm afraid you're right. At this point of the show, we're going to have a special guest, Post Malone. As you can imagine, it wasn't in our budget.
Therefore, we will yield
to the next best thing.
Our next contestant will sing
one of his songs. Will has been playing the guitar for 7 years, and this song happens to be one of his favorites. He is combining the two for us tonight, sponsored by Edmunds Woodworking, and here to perform Feeling Whitney by Post Malone.
Contestant number 10, Kirk.
Told me to wait.
Time, do you ever get into an instrument? And I said, yeah, I can play the radio with no one, with absolutely everyone. It's a volume thing with me. And the louder it is, the better it sounds. So yeah, with that being said, Ms. Ginger Stovall will announce our next pair of contestants.
So you may have noticed that our order was a little out of sync there again, but that's because this duo chose to perform together. So contestant number 8 and 11 are going to pair up.
See what I did there? Yeah.
Okay.
Travis,
he tells some good
jokes. He's good. It's everlasting.
Okay, these two have been the best of friends since they began playing soccer together in elementary school. And if they are that talented on the soccer field, then they must be equally as talented on this stage, right?
Yes.
Whatever the case may be, they agree that they are truly having the time of their lives. See what I did there?
You did.
And to prove it, sponsored by Audubon Dental and McElroy Farms, here are contestants 8 and 11, judges, Xander Wilson and Boone McElroy.
Go Boone!
Now I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's a truth, and I owe it all to you.
Close
party bookings after the night, who knew?
How do we follow that?
I don't know, but Xander looks wonderful in fuchsia. Certainly does.
And the lips.
What? There's that part of the crowd, there must be a gas leak right there in that area. All I can think of.
Or a roof leak.
One or the other. It's affecting. And that's okay. We're here to have a good time tonight. Are we having a good time tonight? That's how we are.
Well, we told them it would be the best $5 they've spent lately.
Absolutely.
So thank you again, crowd and audience.
All right, here we are. Our 12th contestant of the talent portion. Number 12 is Dylan Moore, a natural performer of hip-hop and one to always entertain. Dylan jumped at the opportunity to take to the stage again. I mean, if the Evansville Iceman enjoyed it, why shouldn't we? Sponsored by Farmer Performing to the mix of great hits. Here is Dylan, get jiggy with it.
I don't see how you can hate from outside of the club. You can't even get in. Leg out.
At the end of the talent portion, what do you think? Josh, you can breathe now. Thank you, Josh. I appreciate it. Is that your dress hoodie? Sunday, you're an officer and a gentleman. You remember that. What? Well, you know, when you're on chef,
what?
Barbecue and more, you are going to smell like brisket from time to time. That's a good smell, though. I'm just saying. All right, here we go. Onward and upward. Our 13th and final contestant of the talent portion is contestant 13, Drew Kaser. Drew has enlisted in the Army National Guard and completed basic training during the summer between his junior and senior year. Congratulations
that
on
that. That means he's employed right now.
That means he's in shape.
He's been making money going to school.
Is that right? I wish I'd done that when I worked here. Tonight, for his talent, he will demonstrate how to successfully assist a fallen comrade who has been wounded on the battlefield. Here is contestant number 13, Drew Kaser, with the casualty crawl. Give it up.
Keep your spirits together.
It's hard. It's uphill battle. It's a path less taken, but the beaten path everyone else takes. It's a path that leads to character. You gotta earn that.
But it's worth it. It's worth believing. It's worth fighting. You can do it. You can do it.
It's not the potential of the individual. It's not the genetics. It's the perseverance. The never say die attitude. We all fall down in life. The question is, who gets back up? If you constantly keep throwing shit against the wall, eventually something will stick. Never give in to what you want.
Adversity causes some cats to break and other cats to break records. It's about what you're made out of, not the circumstance.
Every single one of you who is struggling right now, you need to understand this. What you're going through right now is necessary.
Yeah. All right, that concludes the talent portion of tonight's show. We would like to ask the moms of the contestants to please head to the lobby and meet Maggie at this time.
Maggie Moore will be out there waiting for you, and I'll be out there momentarily. Meanwhile, now is your opportunity, audience. Get your QR code out if you haven't done so already, because we're giving you the chance to pick your favorite so far. I understand if you want to wait a little bit longer, but now you only get to vote one time using your QR code. Look at those phones light up. There are people here,
right,
Steve.
Yeah, I want to say congratulations on you being the largest crowd that we've had of the 3 years. I want to say maybe tonight's crowd might be the equivalent of seasons 1 and 2.
Combined,
absolutely.
So look at them. They're discussing and they're voting. They're excited.
And of course, tomorrow morning, Ginger will be back on again, and we'll have the winner of the Mr. Colonel on the show at 6:30 tomorrow morning at 96.5 AM WSON. It'll be on C-Town, the morning show, and we'll have that winner tonight. That's the kind of the
we didn't tell them that part.
Yeah, the paradox of winning is that you get to win one, pick up early the next morning, and then still have a full day of school on a Friday. But it's usually a lot of fun, and we'll talk about the preparation that went into winning the Mr. Colonel event, as well as how excited they are to get up early and profess that they are a winner.
You hear them?
I do. I think they're discussing amongst themselves their voting options. And
take the opportunity to vote now, because again,
you'd hate for it to come down to maybe your vote, your favorite. You know what? I'll just let everybody else vote, and that's how other people win.
Do you see how you hope they're listening, but maybe they're not, and how teaching a class would go?
I have complete. Yeah, that's okay. Fine. That's it. We'll about an hour. Whatever. So, again, looking forward to it. Now, you also, with us, Dr. Michelle Fell. Thank you so much, dear. I've worked with your son, okay?
He's not. She doesn't claim him tonight.
He's not your son tonight. Okay. I am going to speak to him. I'm going to speak to Keelan. Maybe as soon as I leave the stage. But again, we're so glad to have you here tonight. Kyle, you were sitting in the same two spots like last year, like maybe last year, the year before. Have you left? You just a hangout guy. Josh is normally in bed in about, what, 30 minutes? Ago. Yeah, you know, I'm sorry, about 6:30. No, because pulled pork is going to smoke. Absolutely. Tomorrow's special? Tomorrow, okay, very good. Very good. Of course, my co-host has abandoned me, and I don't know anymore. I know one dad joke, but I really don't feel like it's something that you would appreciate. I want to tell it anyway. Guy walks into his psychiatrist's office and says, "Doctor, I'm a wigwam, I'm a teepee, I'm a wigwam, I'm a teepee." And the doctor says, "Relax, you're too tense." Thank you. I told you it was bad, and I prefaced it by being bad. I apologize. I own that joke. So I have no problem with that. I figured you would. Again, another shout out to our good friend at WSON, Pam Pfister Clark with Gallery Gifts and Bridal. Thank you for the sign, lady.
That's so very nice.
Did you make one for Miss Stovall? Say no.
We did.
Ah, dang it.
No,
but anyway, thank you again for that, ladies. That's very, very sweet of you. But I'd just like to say, again, Gallery Gifts and Bridal, fantastic. You got prom coming up, hopefully about 10 years down the road. You've got a wedding coming, bridal gowns, tuxedos, dinner jackets, you name it. Gallery Gifts and Bridal, Main Street here in Henderson. Ginger, where are we at now? Get the curtains open, please.
Oh,
look,
see.
I look proud. Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, judges,
All right, let's now begin the formal wear competition, escorting our clients this year, our extra special guest tonight. Each contestant graciously asked his mom to be his escort tonight. After all, they wouldn't be here if it weren't for her. Number one, escorted by his lovely mother, Diane, contestant number one is Cole Alexander, Intelligent Parish. Cole is a member of SOFA, specifically Band and Percussion Ensemble. He is an ambassador, Leadership Dynamics, and a member of the Colonel Crew. Cole is the son of Mark and Diane Parrish. His favorite color is black, and he just finished binging The Witcher. One fun fact about him is that he was a kid model. His plans after high school is to attend UK and major in chemistry with a minor in biology. Cole's idea of a perfect date includes going out to dinner and then watching the stars. Okay, Cole, if you would. Cole, let me ask you something. Are you nervous? All right, that's what I wanted to hear. Cole, tell us about the teacher who made the biggest impact on your educational experience. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one, Cole Alexander Parrish. Thank you for your subtlety. Contestant number two, escorted by his loving mother, Carla. Contestant number two is Breck Patrick Bender, also known as Charismatic. Breck is the son of Patrick and Carla Bender. He's a member of the Student Council, Leadership Dynamics, National Technical Honor Society, the golf team, and is an ambassador. Breck is the senior class president, Mr. Senior, and County Anna King. Breck was voted on by his peers and was named as best leader for the class of 2022 and says his favorite color is maroon and white, of course. After graduation, Breck plans to attend USI to major in accounting. The most recent show he binged was Last Chance U, and his idea of the perfect date, picking her up, taking her to a restaurant where we meet up with all the boys to see if they approve. If they do, then take her home and plan another date. Oh, and shake her father's hand, of course. Breck, if you would. Which of the yearly hashtags has inspired you the most and why? Hashtag make a wave, hashtag design your destination, hashtag press play, or hashtag the time is now.
Well, Steve, my answer to that will be hashtag press play. Me and my fellow student council members here worked real hard over the summer to determine that would be our slogan this year. And, you know, it was good to get with them over summer a lot and meant a lot. And just kind of built things around that for the year. So make it music based and a lot. Awesome.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number two, Brett Patrick Charismatic Bender. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number three, escorted by his lovely mother, Melissa, is Brecken Michael Exquisite Sauer. Brecken is the son of John and Melissa Sauer. Brecken is an ambassador, a member of the Leadership Dynamics class, Colonel Cast News, and the Y Club. He's also a senior varsity football player. Mr. Sauer plans to attend USI, where he will major in broadcast television and radio. Uh-oh. Looking over my shoulder. One fun fact about Brecken. One time he totaled his car on the way to his 18th birthday dinner. Well done, sir. He most recently binged Yellowstone, and his idea of a perfect date, take her to her favorite restaurant, pay for her dinner, and after that do whatever she wants to do, because in the end, it doesn't matter what guys want. It's always what girls want because guys are never right. Okay. Brecken, if you would. Thank you. Tell us about a challenge you faced here at Henderson County High School and how you were able to overcome it.
Well, Steve, I have to go with COVID. I know COVID impacted a lot of people. It took away half of my sophomore year and most of my junior year. And it's a very big challenge for, I think, everyone that went to school here and every teacher, faculty, and a board member. So I just studied my best, got a bunch of points, and tried to keep my grades up as best as I could, and so did everyone else.
Ladies and gentlemen, Brecken Michael Sauer. Escorted by his lovely mother, Diana. Contestant number four is Hayden Nicholas Inquisitive Emick. He is the son of Alan and Diana Emick. Hayden is a member of the Leadership Dynamics Colonel Crew and serves as an ambassador. After graduation, Hayden plans to attend UK to major in biology. His favorite color is orange, and his most recent binge watching was to Yellowstone. Hayden's idea of the perfect date, getting dinner and going for a walk. Hayden, if you would. All right. Hayden, if you could have any superhuman power, what would it be and why? It's a great answer. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, Hayden Nicholas Emmett. Escorted by his lovely mother, Jill, contestant number five is Jaden Eric Tall Dibler. Jaden is the son of Gerald and Jill Dibler. He is on the automotive pathway of the CTE unit. After graduation, Jaden plans to continue working as a mechanic to save money to go to auto school. Fun fact about Jaden, he has three tattoos. His idea of the perfect date, to be outside fishing with some good food. All right, Jaden, if you would. What is the best thing about living in Henderson?
I think the best thing about living in Henderson is it's a small town, but it's kind of big, so there's a lot of area to cover, a lot of stuff to do around the town. The Mexican restaurants are really good. It's also, there's a lot of local businesses, and there's a lot of people that will help you out, and a lot of nice people that want to stay with you.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number five, Jaden Eric Dibler. By his lovely mother, Tiffany. Contestant number six is Travis Wyatt Outgoing Herndon. Travis is the son of Preston and Tiffany Herndon. He is a member of FFA and the bass fishing team. This fall, Travis plans to attend Eastern Kentucky University to major in business management. Fun fact about Travis, he has his own YouTube channel. Most recently, Travis binge-watched The Witcher. His favorite color is green. And his idea of a perfect date, he packs a picnic and takes her fishing. All right, Travis, if you would. If you could go back in time, what advice would you give your middle school self as you come back to high school?
So the advice that I would give myself is probably do not be afraid to try new things. Because my freshman year, I was not willing to participate in any clubs. I really tried to get out of doing anything extracurricular related. I just wanted to go to school, go home, be done with it. And then sophomore year, I was really pushed a certain someone to get more involved in FFA, and it really helped me grow as a person. And because of that, I'm actually down here. I could have talked, but not made any sense. So now I can at least talk and even know what I'm saying.
Ladies and gentlemen, Travis Wyatt Herndon. joined by his lovely mother, Jonda. Contestant number 7 is Hugh Patrick H.P. Well-Rounded Hazelwood. H.P. is the son of Mike and Jonda Hazelwood. He's a member of the FBLA, the golf team, and serves as an ambassador. This fall, you will find H.P. at Ole Miss, majoring in mechanical engineering. His favorite color is baby blue, and his zodiac sign is Aries. One fun fact about H.P., he has chipped his tooth 11 times. Recently, H.P. has been watched Friday Night Lights, and his idea of the perfect date, Krispy Kreme, hot and ready with that special someone. H.P., if you would. Who is the family member that has the greatest influence on you?
Well, that has to be my sister. She always tells me what's cool and kind of what's not cool, and stops me from doing some dumb things. So I have to say that.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 7, Hugh Patrick H.D. Hazelwood. Escorted by his lovely mother, Crystal, contestant number 8 is Xander Owen Athlete Wilson. Xander is the son of Damian and Crystal Wilson. He's a member of the boys' soccer team and basketball team. His plans after high school are yet to be determined, but does include playing soccer at the next level. Fun fact about Xander, he has played 2 sports his whole life. Recently, he binge-watched On My Block. His favorite color is blue, and his idea of the perfect date, making your own meal that you'll both enjoy, and then watch a movie at your own crib. Go ahead. I'll ask you the questions if it's okay. If you could, what is the one thing you would change to improve Henderson County High School? What's that? No, we can't draw another one. Take something that you might not appreciate about the school. What would make it better? And you can't say the size of the school. Can't do anything about that.
More,
less homework. I like that. That's good enough for me, ladies and gentlemen. A big hand, Xander Owen Wilson. Escorted by his lovely mother, Elise, contestant number 9 is Tyler Joshua Jeremy Outgoing May. Tyler is the son of Elise May and Jeremy May. He's a member of Colonel's Corner Bank, FBLA, Sofa Theater, and Colonel Crew. This fall, Tyler plans to major in business marketing at the University of Kentucky. Fun fact about Tyler, he is 12.5% Lebanese. His favorite color is blue, and his most recent binge is Daredevil and Cobra Kai. Tyler's idea of the perfect date, his words, quote, as cliche as it sounds, any date I go on is a perfect date as long as I'm with my girlfriend, unquote. That's right. All right, Tyler, if you would. What has been your favorite high school experience?
There's a lot. If I had to pick one, I would probably say doing the play this last year. It was Miracle on 34th Street, and I just recently got back in the theater, and I wish I'd done it a lot sooner. And that makes me hear what people thought about me, but that was for sure one of the best experiences I've had here at Henderson County High School.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tyler Joshua Jeremy Bay! Escorted by his lovely mother, Alicia. Contestant number 10 is Will Thomas Aspiring Forker. Will is the son of Alicia Sheridan and Tommy Forker. He's a member of FBLA and the Y Club. He's a student ambassador, a CTE ambassador. Also serves as external president for Colonel's Corner Bank. After graduation, Will plans to attend UK to major in biomedical engineering. His favorite color is green, and his most recent binge, Drive to Survive. Fun fact about Will, his initials, WTF, of which he thanks his mom. Will's idea of the perfect date is to go on an adventure and then watch a movie. All right, Will, if you would. How has being a part of the Mr. Colonel show impacted your life? Ladies and gentlemen, if you would, a big hand, Will Thomas Forker. Escorted by his lovely stand-in, Leah Newman, for his lovely mother, Jennifer, contestant number 11, is Boone Thomas Extravagant McElroy. Boone is the son of Douglas and Jennifer McElroy. He is a member of the Colonel's soccer team. This fall, Boone plans to attend the University of Mississippi and pursue the pre-law track. He is a fond of the color red, and his zodiac animal happens to be a goat. Fun fact about Boone, he has split his head open multiple times as a toddler, which explains a lot about current day Boone. Recently, Boone binged watched The Punisher, and his idea of the perfect date, late night cruise and some good old fast food. Boone, if you would. Describe a valuable life lesson you are taking with you as a graduate of Henderson County High School.
So a valuable life lesson I'm taking with me is for sure to just be myself when everything comes together. Like whenever I'm up in front of a crowd, just like this, I just know to be me, because if I'm not me, then I'm not who I want to be. That's how I want to go through life.
Ladies and gentlemen, Boone Thomas McElroy. Escorted by his lovely mother, Susanna, contestant number 12 is Dylan Dion Dedicated Moore. He is involved in FBLA, NTHS, Skills USA, Student Ambassadors, CTE Ambassadors, and Leadership Dynamics. He serves as Region 1 FBLA President, Henderson County High School FBLA President, and the Henderson County High School Skills Vice President. Following graduation, Dylan will attend USI to major in business, administration, and minor in human resources. Dylan enjoys exercising, playing with his Australian shepherds, and working when not involved at the high school. His favorite food is currently spaghetti Alfredo. His favorite color is blue, and he most recently binge-watched the Netflix series Manifest. His idea of a perfect date would include eating at an elegant restaurant, then going stargazing. Fun fact about Dylan, he used to be an avid hip-hop dancer, as we saw tonight. Dylan, if you would. Describe yourself in song lyrics.
Don't stop till you're on top.
There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, Dylan Dion Moore. Escorted by his lovely mother, Candace, contestant number 13 is Drew Aaron Loyal Kaser. Drew is the son of Candace Yates and Terry Kaser. Drew is a member of the criminal law classes here at Henderson County High School. This past summer, Drew completed his basic training and is already a member of the Army National Guard. Immediately upon graduation, Drew will follow his dad's footsteps and continue his career with the Army National Guard as he leaves to be stationed for Fort Leonard Wood in Missouri. Please take a moment to note that Drew is in his official dress uniform as a tribute to his late friend Ron. His favorite color is black, and his most recent binge-watch series, MTV series, Scream. His idea of the perfect date would definitely include scary movies, if you would. What does it mean to be a colonel?
I think to be a colonel, it means that you have to respect everyone and everything, always be there for every student, no matter if they're good or bad, you gotta always be there for them, and you gotta overall be supportive and respect no matter what.
Drew Aaron Kaser. That is contestant number 13, and that is the conclusion of tonight's Formal Well competition. We are glad that you were able to see each of the contestants looking so sharp tonight, and they did, and I thought the answers were fantastic. How about that indeed?
How about bringing in a microphone that works?
Yeah, how about that? That was a big deal there. Yeah, exactly.
I pointed the wrong way, but that's okay.
That's quite all right. What do we have? What's coming up? I don't have anything here in front of me.
That, my friends, concludes the competition.
Okay. And so we're going to take a brief.
We're going to take a brief intermission. We're going to escort the judges out because we have some tabulating that needs to happen. Bring us some lights. Everybody, make sure you take this last opportunity to donate to the best legs and see where we go with that.
Yep. Maybe check the concession stand for a little bit, and we'll check back in about.
We're going to close the QR code voting as well, so that we can roll into some awards. Can we do a time check when we talk about this?
Right now, we're at 7:24.
What? Okay. So, lights up, intermission. We'll see you back in a few.
All right, folks. Take care.
Okay. Thank you. We lost our signal about 30 minutes in. Came right back.
Thank you.
better than me. Of course not. What everybody think of the show tonight? Right, it fits a little snug. Exactly. I'm asking you a question. You want me to read that? Okay. Assisting Ms. Snowball with the awards tonight will be co-directors of the show, Jaden Powell and Jordan Troutman. After the announcement of the winners, we'd like for all the contestants to remain on stage for pictures. No one goes home empty-handed as we have curtain, please. It's all about rehearsal, guys. Don't miss it. Here they are. No one goes home empty-handed, as we all are winners. With that, I will reach into my left pocket and pull out a gaggle of gifts. There's one set.
Ta-da.
And another set.
In their pockets. So, tell them what they're getting, Steve.
Okay, each contestant tonight is receiving a car wash token to receive a free car wash from Whiteout's Car Wash on South Green. And a coupon to Henderson Nutrition. Another gift that was just added just moments ago, the winner of this competition, after they come on the Steve Tao Morning Show tomorrow, keeping up with the Colonel's Friday Morning Edition, at 6:30 a.m., you get a free breakfast sandwich from... No. Don't cut me off, guys. You're getting a free meal... Don't cut me off from our friends at Chef What Barbecue and More, Mr. Josh and Amy Bennett. Thank you. All right. You may have noticed the chicken leg buckets in the lobby. Those buckets traveled around the cafeteria, and the student body were given the opportunity to vote for the best legs with a penny a vote system. The votes have been counted. The best legs winning package includes. As we speak, all right, there we go. Our lovely assistant, thank you, Jordan. A KFC bucket full of socks and slides from Tip Top, a can koozie and sticker from Sweet Peas, a class of 2022 hoodie from Johnston's, and a fresh fried chicken legs from the Dodge store. The best legs of the night go to Travis Herndon! Yes, I have. Have you seen his legs in real life? On Stage Award, this award is given to the contestant that showed the most sincere, well-thought-out answer to the question that was drawn out of the bowl. The winning package includes a bucket of fun to clean his car, donated by Fiberboard, $25 cash from Dr. Jennings, a gift certificate to the Marketplace here at school, a free smoothie from Henderson Juice Company, $20 cash from Friel's Machine, and a bouquet of flowers, compliments of Shaw's Flowers. This prize package goes to Travis Herndon! And welcome to the Travis Herndon Show. It's been a big waste of time the last 90 minutes. We were just going to get to Travis in the first. All right, next up, I know you're on the edge of your seat for the Fitness Award. This award is given to the most outstanding performance tonight, as chosen by the judges. This fabulously fit young man will get a haircut at Sweet Beauty, a free smoothie from Henderson Juice Company, $25 gift card to a choice of a restaurant from Dr. Paige Warren, DMD, also a big brick of soap and loofah from Sweet Peas, and a $10 gift certificate to Henderson Nutrition, and the LED were donated by Escalade Sports, as you can see right here. So, the winner, H.B. Hazelwood. Well done, young man. Well done. The next award is Mr. Congeniality. This award was voted on by our contestants this evening. The winning package includes a $25 gift card to Palmer's Gas Card, a Duke Cannon chapstick, and a pair of socks from Sweet Peas, a Colonel's Cooking Crazy Lunch, and a mini cooler since he kept his cool throughout the whole experience, according to the contestants. Tonight's Mr. Congeniality is Drew Kaser! The Crowd Favorite Award. The results are in, and you, the crowd, have voted on using the QR code on your program. And we know that you picked as the crowd favorite tonight. He receives a prize package that includes two tickets to Showplay Cinemas, a Colonel's Cooking Crazy's lunch, and a $50 Sureway gift certificate. The crowd's favorite is Xander Wilson. Now we have the Mr. Smarty Pants Award. Scholastic achievement. Earlier this evening, the judges reviewed the transcripts of the contestants, and after careful deliberation, they selected this young man as the Smarty Pants of the bunch. The winning package includes the Henderson County High School academics fees being waived, a $15 gift card to Rookies, a candle from Sweet Peas, and a college of his choice sweatshirt, and a Columbia backpack. Tonight's Mr. Smarty Pants is Dylan Moore. Next, we have the Talent Award. The judges were asked to carefully select the contestant who shined in the category of talent. The winning package includes two tickets to Showplay Cinemas, a t-shirt, a drawstring bag, and two face masks from the Dance Factory, two free meals from Artie's, and a Visa gift card from Independence Bank. The winner, Travis Herndon! Giving up now the top three awards. Second runner-up, a prize package with over $130, which includes a Marketplace sweatshirt, one free meal from Arby's, a free lunch from Colonel's Cooking Crazies, two tickets to Showplay Cinemas, one prom ticket. Who's writing these? All right. $25 cash donated by Bill Heath's Family Sports, and a $25 cash donated by KT Williams Law, LLC. Your second runner-up is Boone McElroy. And now, your first runner-up, a prize package worth $155, includes two tickets to Showplay Cinema, one free lunch from Arby's, a Marketplace sweatshirt, one free lunch from the Colonel Cooking Crazies, one prom ticket, $25 cash donated by KT Williams Law, LLC, and $50 donated by Hometown Roots. Your first runner-up goes to Travis Herndon. Here, Mr. Colonel, for the class of 2022, the prize package is worth, well, priceless. Free basketball ticket to the game of your choice provided by the athletic department, one reserved parking spot, two prom tickets, one free lunch from Arby's, a free school yearbook, a marketplace sweatshirt, two tickets to Showplace Cinemas, $100 cash, and a medal here to proudly wear at graduation. Ladies and gentlemen,
your
class of 2022, Mr. Colonel, is Tyler May! Sell reserved parking pass. No, it's got to be your car in that spot. Who did you? So, Ms. Stovall, you want to say for them not to clear out of here in just a moment because we want to get pictures, right?
All right, we need a picture for the yearbook. We need a picture with the Leadership Dynamics class. Or we'll have a round of applause for those students.
We couldn't get this done. We appreciate the participation of our judges, Kyle Forrester, Josh Bennett, and of course, Dr. Michelle Chappelle. Give them a big round of applause, too. Thank you so much for making this event what it is. Ms. Stovall, this is third Mr. Colonel event in as many years, and it just gets better every year.
I think so. We make notes, we'll tweak, and we'll work on some things, and we'll get
it. All right, thanks so much for attending. This third annual Leadership Dynamics Mr. Contest. Once again, thanks to all of our sponsors and volunteers. I want to thank our friends at Gallery Gifts and Bridal, Ms. Pam Pfister, to have look this good normally. I promise you on that one. Ask my wife. But again, thank you so much, Pam. Again, thank you to all of our sponsors.